Anh là hạnh phúc
سيئات أعمالنا. من يهده الله فلا مضل له، ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. All praise is due to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Lord of the world and the most merciful. I bear witness that there is no God but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And I bear witness that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is the messenger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and his slave. My dear brother and sister in Islam, I advise myself first and I advise all of you to establish the fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the deepest of your heart and try to practice it in your daily life. My dear brother and sister in Islam, in this khutbah we would like to welcome the one of the most honored visitor who is coming soon. We are really exciting to meet him, to meet this visitor. This visitor is a blessing from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The question is that, did you make yourself ready to invest every single moment in your life and your time to invest the time during this visitor? Did you attempt to welcome this visitor? I assume that all of you is recognized and knows what I mean by this visitor. The visitor is Ramadan, and the holy month of Ramadan, the one of the five pillars of Islam. Dear brother and sister in Islam, we are in this month of Sha'ban, and so there are just a few weeks to reach Ramadan. Our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to say, Allahumma barik lana fi Rajab wa Sha'ban wa ballighna Ramadan. The translation is that we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bless us in Sha'ban, in Rajab and Sha'ban, and help us to reach Ramadan with good health. My dear brother and sister in Islam, the word of Ramadan in Arabic, what does it mean? Ramadan is come from Arabic root, which is it? Ar-Ramdha. And Ar-Ramdha mean in English is scorching and dryness. So the Ramadan when is coming is scorching your bad deeds and is merciful from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and forgiveness. My dear brother and sister in Islam, Do you know why Ramadan is scorching? Because the devil and the shaitan is arrested and blocked in this holy month of Ramadan. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned in the Holy Quran that, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا كُتِبَ عَلَيْكُمُ الصِّيَامُ كَمَا كُتِبَ عَلَى الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِكُمْ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ. The translation is that, oh, his belief, the fast has been obligatory and mandatory on you, as it's made for the people before you, in order to be righteous and good person. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed one holy surah about Laylatul Qadr, which is one night of Ramadan. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made one surah, the entire of surah, which include almost 5 verses, about the Holy Quran, about the Ramadan, and not about the entire of Ramadan, it's just for one night of Ramadan. What does it mean? If just one night of Ramadan has all this advantage, what about the rest of the Ramadan? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said that, إِنَّا أَنزَلْنَاهُ فِي لَيْلَةِ الْقَدْرِ وَمَا أَدُرَاكَ مَا لَيْلَةُ الْقَدْرِ. At the end of the surah, however, the translation is that, indeed, we revealed the Holy Quran in the night of the power, in the night of Laylatul Qadr, and what will explain to you the night of the power is, the night of the power, the night of Laylatul Qadr is better than 1,000 months, is better than 1,000 months, and the angels is descends after Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala permission to the world, and the night has peace until the dawn, until the fajr. So of all this advantage has been made from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in this night, so about the whole of the month. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make Laylatul Qadr better than 1,000 of the month. Approximately 83 years, according to Islamic calendar. My dear brother and sister in Islam, you can imagine that one night in Ramadan is better than 1,000 of the month. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless you to invest this night, you will be in good position. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give you the good plus, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala appointed to practice and invest this night. My dear brother and sister in Islam, the companion of our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to congratulate us when Ramadan is coming. So on the first day of Ramadan, the companions of our Prophet, peace be upon him, said that congratulations, the Ramadan, you reached the day of the Ramadan, the first day of the Ramadan. Allah bless you. Allah make you alive to reach this Ramadan. So if the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, before Ramadan, 2 months in Rajab and Sha'ban, those before Ramadan, our Prophet used to ask Allah before Ramadan 2 months in order to allow him to reach this month. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to help us to reach Ramadan with good health and good intention, to practice and invest every single moment in this holy month. My dear brother and sister in Islam, there is a question. Why Ramadan is unique? Why Ramadan is special in Muslim life? There are a lot of things, but we are going to mention just 5 things which make Ramadan is unique in Muslim life. The first one is fasting. Is fasting. As you know, the fasting is the one of the 5 pillars of Islam. You're not Muslim, at least you have to fast in Ramadan. Except if you have excuse which mentioned Holy Quran and our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. And the fasting is not just to stop, eat or drink during the day, from the dawn to the dusk, no. From the fajr to the sunset, no. You have to or stop the bad manner, where you have to be your tongue made, and you have to be your tongue is made by dhikr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. and make your tongue moist by dhikr Allah, with dhikr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Reciting Quran, keep away from the bad deeds. You have to fast your stomach and fast your deeds and your every single of your body has to be fasting. Not just fast from this food or drink, no. The fasting is test from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to be Muslim. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tests you if you are really Muslim or not. Because Islam is not easy. Islam is a plus from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. However, Allah tests you if you are really Muslim or not. So you have to stop eating and drink and everything break your fasting. That's why our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned that if somebody deal bad deeds with him, said to him, I'm fasting. So my fasting ban me and protect me to response you in bad manner. The second thing is Ramadan is our guide. As you know, the Holy Quran is revealed in this month. And in one night, which is it Laylatul Qadr. Ramadan is the month of the Holy Quran. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala appointed Ramadan to reveal this Holy Quran in Laylatul Qadr. And this is why Ramadan is a unique month for our Muslim life. The third unique is Ramadan has Laylatul Qadr. And if you believe that or not, Laylatul Qadr is better than 1,000 months. If you pray one time in Laylatul Qadr, like you pray 1,000 of month, like you pray almost 83 years. Who knows, you are alive nowadays, but who knows for the next Ramadan, you'll be alive or no. Allah knows. So how many people use with us last month? Even last year, but nowadays they are in the grave. But Allah bless you to be alive, to do more deeds, and invest every mercy month from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Also, the gates of heaven are open in Holy Ramadan. That's why the angel used to say that in Ramadan, oh, he's looking for good deeds coming. And who is looking for bad deeds, keep away. Ya baghiya al-khayri aqbil. وَيَا بَاغِيَ الشَّرِّ أَدْبِرْ. Who is looking for good deeds, this coming. And who is looking for bad deeds, keep away. This is the month of worship. This is the month of ibadah. This is the month of merciful. This is the month for Muslim. So that's why even the devil and shaitan arrested and blocked in this Ramadan. Unfortunately, some human and some Muslim people ask Shaitan if he is stopped and arrested. He said to Shaitan, don't worry, I will make your work instead of you. So you are arrested, so I will do your bad work to the Muslim. That's why we have to protect and ourselves from the prohibited and from the bad and from the bad manner. Fasting is not just, as I mentioned before, just keep away from food and drink. No. You have to practice your good manner and make your tongue is dhikr with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and reciting Quran. Also, Ramadan is unique because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala increases your reward. So if you are, as I mentioned, if you are fasting in Ramadan, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will increase your reward. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless us by this month. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward to increase his reward. So if we recite Quran, as our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that, I don't mention that alif lam mim as one letter. However, the alifun is letter and lam is letter and mim is letter. So alif lam mim has three letter. And as you know, how many Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will reward you in one letter if you are reciting Quran. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala asked us to recite Quran in the holy month, and Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to review the holy Quran in the holy month of the Ramadan with Jibreel alayhi salatu wa sallam. My dear brother and sister in Islam, How we make ourselves ready for Ramadan? How we make ourselves ready for Ramadan? There are something we have to keep in mind to invest in Ramadan by good manner and try to worship and do ibadah in the right way. First of all, you need to clean up your time. You need to clean up your time. So you try to memorize your chat on the phone. It is really take hours without notice. So if you use your phone, the time is going without your notice. So you have to believe that the phone is waste your time. It's pointless. The phone is not, encourage you to do good worship or ibadah. Otherwise, if you have or if you are dedicated to use this phone, try to use it in good manner and good way. Such as there are a lot of apps in iPhone or Windows or something like that. You know, you can download the Holy Quran and recite Quran through the iPhone, through your smartphone. Instead of waste your time or go to a website or chatting with somebody else, Allah bless us nowadays with something really make us easy to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and make ibadah, such as iPhone, such as Windows, such as smartphone. So you can, this is good to invest your time with when you download the Holy Quran and try to recite the Quran through this app. Also, this is the message especially for ladies. So for cooking, some people just believe that Ramadan is time for cooking. Ramadan is time for party. Ramadan is time for ask people to come to visit you. My dear brother and sister in Islam, especially my sister, Ramadan is the time for worship. Ramadan is the time for ibadah. Ramadan, this is a good opportunity for you. This is a good chance for you. If you have to stay at kitchen and cooking, at least you can have tab and try the step to be working and reciting Quran. Otherwise, don't waste your time in kitchen for 3 or 4 hours. This is waswas. This is the thought of shaitan. Come to your mind. And ask to cook, blah, blah, blah. The question is that, why the devil and shaitan does not come to you in Sha'ban or during the whole year, except in Ramadan? And he came to you. And he just asked, the shaitan thought, come to your mind and ask to cook him something new or something, you just know nowadays. If you really wanted to be in kitchen, please, my sister, even please my brother, try to make something, invest your time in a good way, such as you have to have tablet and make it reciting Quran while you are cooking. Also, some people believe that Ramadan is time for shopping. Ramadan is time for ibadah, not for shopping. As you know, with the Eid, we have to buy some new clothes for Eid. You can't buy right now. You can't buy right now to save your time in Ramadan. Also, sleeping. Unfortunately, a lot of people nowadays, especially Muslims, try to increase their sleeping. They are sleeping during this Ramadan. We don't ask you to cut your sleeping. And we don't ask you to decrease your sleeping. No. Sleep as you sleep right now. However, don't increase your sleeping, especially in the day of the Ramadan. Some people say that, I can't stay a day and practice my daily life, normal life, while I'm fasting. No, you can. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make fasting mandatory because He knows that you can't do that. But maybe because your iman is weak. Maybe because your belief is not as strong as led you to fast. Allah never makes something mandatory to you and you cannot do that. Allah is merciful. Allah loves His believer. The thing is because of you, because of your ibadah, because of your iman. Ask yourself, if you have strong iman, you will fast. except if you have excuse from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, such as if you are sick or if you are traveling or you cannot fast. This is another way. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. الحمد لله على إحسانه والشكر له وعلى توفيقه وامتنانه. My dear brother and sister in Islam, welcome Ramadan. Welcome the holy month from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Welcome the honor month. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to help us to practice the Holy Quran and reciting Holy Quran. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to let us weak from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to help us to do the Ramadan in the right way as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ask us. There are some ibadah we should do, I mean we have to do, especially in Ramadan, such as the prayer. So my dear brother and sister in Islam, I expected and I think, actually I know that all of us practice the five prayer in our daily life and on time. That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala asked to pray Jumu'ah. That means inshallah, all of us is pray our five times on prayer times on the time. However, what about the 12 rak'ah, the sunnah? Our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that Allah, may Allah have mercy on him who pray for rak'ah before asr. Brother, the huge reward from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to you when you just pray four rak'ah before asr. The mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will come to you. Brother and sister, believe or not, just small work, small job will not take more than 5 minutes. Then the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on you and with you. Tell me, my dear brother and sister in Islam, what you will lose if the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with you? Who can harm you if the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is with you? My dear brother and sister in Islam, you have. It's sunnah, but I said you have because this is mercy from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Try to pray 12 rak'ah, the sunnah. Especially for Fajr time and Dhuhr and Maghrib and Isha. Also, my dear brother and sister in Islam, try to pray Taraweeh. Taraweeh, my dear brother and sister in Islam, is Qiyamul Layl. And our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said that whoever pray with Imam in Taraweeh from the beginning at the end, he will consider as pray all the night. If you pray with Imam for 1 hour or 1.5 hour, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will reward you as pray all the night. That's why I said in the beginning of the khutbah that the unique of Ramadan is an increase of reward from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. My dear brother and sister in Islam, If the reward from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is easy to come, so why we plan ourselves to not practice this prayer, especially the Taraweeh and Sunnah from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Also, my dear brother and sister in Islam, you should recite in Quran. At least you should read Quran from the beginning at the end 3 times. At the end, at the least, 3 times. If not, 2 times. If not 1 time, if not you have every day to read and recite Quran, 3-4 pages. You don't have an excuse. While you are driving, while you are in your job, while you are in your work, just try to recite in Quran. This is the month of Quran. This is the month of Quran. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala relieved this Quran in Ramadan. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala relieve this Quran in Ramadan. If you do not recite in Quran, tell me what kind of Muslim you are. Tell me what kind of Muslim you are. This is, my dear brother and sister in Islam, mercy from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And if you recite Quran in the right way, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will reward you 1 time. And if you recite Quran and find it hard to recite Quran because it's in Arabic and you speak another language, Allah will reward you twice. Allah will reward you twice because you recite Quran and you find some difficulty. Look to the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Brother and sister in Islam, this is your time. This is your opportunity. This is your chance to ask you Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to help you to infest this holy month of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Also, there is one unique thing in Ramadan, which is its supplication, which is its dua. My dear brother and sister in Islam, the supplication and dua for Ramadan is acceptable. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that لِلصَّائِمِ عِنْدَ إِفْطْرِهِ دَعْوَةٌ لَا تُرَدْ. The person who is fasting has acceptable dua during his fast. This is from our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. This is the hadith, as our Prophet said that. My dear, you have acceptable dua during your breakfast, when the sun set. Why you don't raise your hand? Why you don't raise your hand and ask Allah whatever you need? Why, my dear brother and sister in Islam? Unfortunately, nowadays, if you look to the normal life of Muslim, even the time of breakfast, during the break, before the breakfast, just talking about the dunya, about the worst thing. Brother, this is opportunity. Don't miss this one. Please, my dear brother and sister in Islam, make dua for yourself and your parents and the people around you, and for also Ummah Muslim. For Ummah Muslim, please. Ummah Muslim need your dua. The nation of Muslim really need your dua. Please, especially the old women and men, raise your hand and just teach your sons and daughter to raise their hand and make dua, because their sins is small. The children and young people, they commit small sins, not like us. So maybe Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will accept from them more than you. Also, my dear brother and sister Islam, try to teach your son and daughter to fasting. Try to make them ready before it comes mandatory and obligatory for them. Try to teach them how they fast and encourage them to fast. My dear brother and sister in Islam, in Ramadan we have last 10 days, which called Ashr al-Awakhir. You should make i'tikaf. I'tikaf is mean stay in masjid all the day and make attention. The last thing I suggest all of you to do, just make intention. Allah will reward you when you make intention. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will reward you when you make intention. Even you cannot do that what you have intent, Allah will reward you. Just make attention. Write notes that in Ramadan I will recite Quran 3 times. From the beginning to the end. In Ramadan, I will make a charity. In Ramadan, I will help people and help some masjid for a charity. In Ramadan, I will do so and so and so. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will reward you by your intention. Even you cannot do that, Allah will reward you. Please, my brother and sister in Islam, try to encourage yourself to do what I have mentioned in this khutbah and whatever I have don't mention, and it is good, ibad and worship. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us a new life during Ramadan. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to refreshment our life in Ramadan. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to reach the night of the power. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to reach the night of Laylatul Qadr. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to reach the night of Laylatul Qadr. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bless in this holy month. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to help us for fasting. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make it easy to face some difficulty during our fasting. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to help us reciting Quran. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to help us to make intention. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to help us to make supplication for our parents, for our sons, for our ummah. And أقم الصلاة إن الصلاة كانت على المؤمنين كتابا موقوتا. Thank you.
حي على الصلاة، حي على الصلاة، حي على الفلاح، حي على الفلاح، قد قامت الصلاة، قد قامت الصلاة، الله أكبر، الله أكبر، لا إله إلا الله.
الله أكبر. الحمد لله رب العالمين، الرحمن الرحيم، مالك يوم الدين، إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين، اهدنا الصراط المستقيم، صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. للذين أحسنوا الحسنى وزيادة، ولا يرهق وجوههم قتر ولا ذلة، أولئك أصحاب الجنة هم فيها خالدون. والذين كسبوا السيئات جزاء سيئة بمثلها ويرهقهم ذلة، ما لهم من الله من عاصم، كأنما أغشيت وجوههم قطعا من الليل مظلما، أولئك أصحاب النار هم فيها خالدون. الله أكبر.
الله
سمع الله لمن حمده. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر.
الله
الله أكبر.
الله
الحمد لله رب العالمين، الرحمن الرحيم، مالك يوم الدين، إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين، اهدنا الصراط المستقيم، صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. قل هو الله أحد، الله الصمد، لم يلد ولم يولد ولم يكن له كفوا أحد. الله أكبر.
الله
سمع الله لمن حمده. الله أكبر.
الله أكبر.
الله أكبر.
الله
الله أكبر.
الله
الله أكبر.
الله
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله.